Phonseklak Wanchamkem is a superstar in Thailand, but he lost this week.
say what?
Don't hate. Hey,
what'd you say, man? I couldn't understand you.
Phonseklak Wanchamkem.
Are you cussing at us?
What do you think about Phonseklak?
I think that he was a very accomplished flyweight title holder with like 80 wins on his record and 17 defenses of the flyweight crown, and he was just upset in Thailand over the weekend by some Filipino with like 11 or 12 losses on his record, knocked down like three times in the fight, and then stopped at the end, and a minor upset in the Thai boxing world. I only know it because my girlfriend's Thai.
So he's a legendary fighter, 86 wins on his record. He goes in there for a title defense.
Yeah, Phonseklak Wanchamkem, if that's not a fun name to say, if I ever heard one.
And he fights this dude from the Philippines, and there's a shocker, a guy with 10 losses.
A guy with a ton of losses on his record knocks out this long-reigning Thai flyweight champ right about the time that the worldwide media was starting to give him his just due. And sometimes they say the worst thing you can do is believe your own press. So anyways, this guy with, like 85 or 86 wins on his record goes and loses to a guy with a ton of losses. And a pretty big shock up, I think, in the lower weight class community, and especially
in the Philippines, they were going crazy.
In the Philippines, they're going crazy, and I'm sure they were pretty disappointed in Thailand. And I've been to Thailand myself, and I got a chance to go to a couple of these boxing gyms and actually meet Phonseklak Wanchamkem.
No way. What was it like to go to the gym? Was it like Outlaws? What is the gym?
Nothing like this.
Why?
What's it very third world. Cats don't even wear shoes. They don't have equipment.
Cats don't wear shoes.
They don't wear shoes to the gym, boxing gym.
They kick the bags too, or?
Yeah, because in Thailand, the national sport is kickboxing or Muay Thai. And so most places are Muay Thai gyms, and they happen to do boxing. And some of them have gotten famous for boxing. And there's been many, many Thai world champions all from around that neighborhood, usually very small guys.
So what else was the gym like? You come in there, you see everybody's barefoot. How was their boxing technique like?
You know, look, they knew the basics. They knew to keep their hands up. They knew to try to throw straight punches and set up combinations. There was a huge language barrier, so I couldn't understand what the coaches were instructing their fighters to do. It seemed like they were telling them to do the correct things. And the cool thing was, you know, even halfway around the world in a foreign place, in a foreign language, I was able to communicate these guys through the language of boxing.
You showed them how to hit, how to punch, how to...
Yeah, well, I showed them that, hey, I also live this world, and I was able to garner respect from them.
Did you knock anybody out?
I didn't knock anybody. I didn't do any sparring. I was too busy eating Ratnam noodles and drinking Singha beer. But I was on vacation, you know what I'm saying?
Great, huh?
I love Thai food. It was some of the best eating I've ever done in my life. But just a great community. I mean, think about a place where their national sport is Muay Thai. You know, imagine if our national sport was boxing, you know, how much ingrained it would be into the community. And that's how kickboxing is there. And to some degree, boxing, because it definitely spreads off there. And just like anywhere else in the world, boxing is the sport of the working class and the downtrodden. This is a way for people can pick themselves up and actually make something of themselves. And it's thriving there. And every time I walk around the United States and they tell me how much boxing is dying and how much MMA is taking over, I just remember these communities and countries that I go to where their boxing champions are everything. They're their superheroes. And you can't tell me that this sport is dying. It's alive and well, and it's going global.
Was the gym packed?
Yeah, you know what? I think it was there on a weekend. It was quite some time ago, and there was a fair amount of people training there. I was stoked. I was really happy to see it, and I felt very comfortable there.
And the last thing I want to ask you, what posters did they have on the wall? Do you remember? Any American fighters?
No American fighters. It was all
different.
No
Mayweather posters?
No Mayweather. It was all Thai dudes. Maybe some Filipinos on there, too. A lot of Muay Thai posters.
How come you don't have any Thai fighters or Filipino fighters on your gym wall?
I need to get back to Thailand and go swoop me up
some swag. Go into the gym and walk out with the posters.
You know what I mean?
So there you have it. Phonseklak Wanchamkem. What do you guys think? FiercerReporting.com. I'm Elisek back reporting.